Learn to code. This phrase is now considered offensive, and if you type these three words in a tweet directed at laid-off journalists, you could get you suspended or even banned. It's funny that no one seemed to care when this phrase was directed at coal miners, factory workers, or others who were laid off thanks to Obama's economy-destroying regulatory siege.
No one's born a computer scientist, but with a little hard work and some math and science, just about anyone can become one.
So there were some massive layoffs in the journalism world. You may have heard BuzzFeed and the Huffington Post let some people go. And shortly after this news broke, some started using the hashtag #LearnToCode, some of them directing these tweets to laid off journos. And look, I'm not for kicking people while they're down, and I'm not happy to hear that people lost their jobs. But that being said, I have no issue with calling out the hypocrisy of those whining about being told to learn to code. Why? Because no one cared when former President Barack Obama said it.
What we need to then do is invest in those communities that used to have a lot of coal miners, which was a tough, dirty job. Let's retrain them so that they're the ones who are installing wind turbines.
No one cared when liberal journalists wrote articles encouraging laid-off workers to learn new skills. I mean, look at these headlines. Can you teach a coal miner to code? And here's one by Forbes. It reads, "Turning coal miners into coders and preventing a brain drain." This one, published by NPR, "From Coal to Code, a new path for laid-off miners in Kentucky." And take a look at this one. "Hillbillies Who Code, the Former Miners Out to Put Kentucky on the Tech Map." And we can't forget about the video news reports.
The coal industry has lost more than 40% of its workforce in recent years. Out-of-work miners have had to find jobs in other fields. Weijia Jang tells us about a program in West Virginia that has miners carving out new careers in the bedrock of the computer industry.
According to Garland, the skills that once made Kentucky coal miners so successful carry over naturally to coding.
If Trump really cares about miners, he would be putting a plan in place for their futures as mining continues its long-term decline. But he isn't doing that. Now, luckily, there are some small things being done by others. One company called BitSource in Kentucky has been hiring miners as software programmers and paying them through their retraining.
And here's more food for thought. Not only were a lot of these liberal outlets telling the laid-off workers to go learn code, but the liberal media were working hand in glove with the Obama administration to help push the disastrous job-killing policies. So Twitter will go to bat for sensitive journalists who are offended by the learn to code hashtag, but I don't remember any social media companies going to bat for hardworking Americans who were put on blast at the national level by journalists and politicians. Hardworking Americans have feelings too.
When you make comments like, "We're going to put a lot of coal miners out of jobs," these are the kind of people that you're affecting. This is my family. And while my hope is in God, that's my future. I want my family to know that they have a future here in this state, because this is a great state.